Certain molecules are called diatomic molecules, and these are made up of two atoms of the same element that are bound together by covalent bonds. Now, you may have heard of covalent bonds made up of atoms of different elements, but diatomic molecules are strictly made up of atoms of the same element combining together to form covalent bonds. And by sharing one or more valence electrons through that covalent bond, the atoms can then fill their outer shells. For example, the hydrogen molecule, which looks like this, is a diatomic molecule. And by sharing an electron, each hydrogen atom can fill its outer shell, and the molecule then has one covalent bond. And so a hydrogen atom may look something like this, and then there's two hydrogen atoms in a hydrogen molecule. And so since each hydrogen atom needs one valence electron, or another valence electron to fill its outer shell, the two hydrogen atoms combine forces to share their valence electron with one another, and since a covalent bond is one pair of shared valence electrons, they form a covalent bond right there. Now, there can be more than one covalent bond in a diatomic molecule. An oxygen molecule is formed when two oxygen atoms share two pairs of valence electrons between them. And nitrogen, which looks like that, is formed when two nitrogen atoms share three pairs of valence electrons. So here you have two pairs, and here you have three pairs. So although a hydrogen molecule is a very simple illustration of a diatomic molecule, there can also be two pairs or even three pairs of valence electrons between them. And many gases are diatomic molecules, such as oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, or iodine.